And now that we have our years in addition to our update function, let's put them together in setInterval. The syntax for setInterval is that the first argument it expects is a function to run, and the second argument is the number of milliseconds for the interval to run at. So for this example, we'll run this anonymous function every second or every 1,000 milliseconds, starting 1 second from when setInterval gets called. And the way to stop an interval so it doesn't go on forever is to remember in a variable what interval you set. And inside our function for the interval, we need to put our code that runs the update function and pass it 1 year at a time. In our code here, we're creating an index so we know which year we're at. Inside our function that's called at the specified interval of 1,000 milliseconds, we're running our update function with the specified index to get the correct year from our years array and running update with that year, incrementing the index by 1. And then if the index happens to be greater than the number of elements in our years array, meaning we've gone through every year, pass the year interval, the JavaScript function clearInterval. ClearInterval is simply a built-in JavaScript function that takes as a single argument an interval variable created with setInterval and stops it so that we don't run forever update after update of the World Cup map. To make this a little bit more clear, calling setInterval, it returns an interval object which we're remembering in our year interval variable, which we then are going to pass to clearInterval to stop our function from getting called every 1,000 milliseconds. And now let's save our file and go back to our browser and see how our map animates.